Today's openings begin with Coffee Black Rye Pale Ale from Barnhammer Brewing in Winnipeg. Not much in the way of tasting notes on this one, just rich roasted and coffee flavored. Oh, and apparently it's a strong beer. Alrighty. Wow, a very strong coffee taste in that one. First item in is pads. Doesn't feel very padded. Assortment of what? What are you? Seriously, what are you? Soft, flexible, kind of rubbery? Took me a little while to figure out, but I think those... Yes, they are. Those are semiconductive or conductive pads for the touch switches. Now, this kind of touch switch here that goes down onto tracks on the keyboard and makes a contact across them. I was watching somebody's repair video several months ago, I think like back in April. I remember seeing them using some of these to repair a device. So I figured that would be a really handy thing to have in a variety of sizes. Oh, wow, look at those little fly specks. Those are tiny. In the past, when I've had one of these fail or get unpleasant, I've just cleaned them a whole bunch and they seem to have worked, but I've never actually had one disintegrate. Like, I wish I could remember whose video that was. Anyway, yeah, the one that he had was just glazed over and started to crack and stuff. So now I've got what I need to do that kind of a repair should one come across my workbench. Conductive repair kit for IR remote controllers. 100 pieces conductive pads. 1.5 millimeters all the way up to 10 millimeters. This one cost me $9.45 Canadian with another $1.36 shipping. That's more expensive than what I usually buy, but it was, of course, the cheapest version of this that I could find at the time. So the sizes in the kit are 1.5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 millimeter. 10 of each one. It says that they're about half a millimeter thick, which is about what I measured or what I felt when I was playing with them as well. Right, next thing in is, came to my P.O. box. So that would make this another anonymous donation from a viewer like you. Thank you to whoever sent this. So I wonder what it is. Pin headers. An assortment of pin headers. Just a bunch of standard pin headers for soldering onto circuit boards and either connecting, you know, connectors to, or connecting jumper wires to, or plugging into breadboards. All kinds of uses for these. And as a consumable, I do tend to go through them around here. As always, when it's something that was sent to me rather than something that I've ordered, I don't have a link. So I will link you to a search term that finds essentially the same thing. As always, sort by price plus shipping, lowest first to find the best deal. And the next thing in. What does it say on here? I can't read that. It's too faded. Right. What are you? You are some kind of adapter cables. Ah, these are USB 3 to USB 2 adapter. Oh, I remember now. So this goes onto the motherboard of my shop computer, which is a little bit older than I thought. And this side goes to these USB 3 cables that I got several mailbags back for mounting in the front of my computer to give me more USB access, because I always tend to need to plug USB things in here and I just don't have enough ports on the machine. So there are available motherboard headers, but they turned out to be USB 2 only. So here we go. And yes, they are, do say USB 3, but USB 2, USB is backwards compatible, right? So it should work, I think. Cross my fingers, hopefully.
19/20 pin USB 3 female to USB 2.0 9 pin male motherboard header adapter. Random characters. These cost me $431 with free shipping each, and I got two of them, so $860 something. That's not too bad. Not too much new information down here. What your USB 3.0 20-pin device connect to a USB 2 motherboard header.
Right, next in, this says electrical wires. And yeah, it does kind of feel like a coil of wire, so I wonder what sort of wire it is. It's got a kind of a solid jacket on it. Ah, there we go, we got an end. What do we have? Shielded four conductor, or two twisted pairs, actually. Why would I order shielded two pair? Shielded single pair I could see as microphone cable, but two pair? Let's go and see what I ordered.
5 meter twisted pair shielded cable, 2468 by 24 strands, I guess. Core pure copper wire, 26 to 18 gauge PVC. Okay, PVC shielded control wire. Yeah, so I ordered 22 gauge, 2 core, cost me $11.80 with free shipping. But what I apparently got was 4 core. So I guess I saved a little bit of money, but that's not really what I wanted. I wanted single pair. Doesn't even have a picture of it here. So maybe that was just my fault, but I don't know. That's not really what I wanted. I can still use it, of course. Fairly generic stuff down here. 26, 24, 22 gauge or 20 gauge. PVC sheath shielding plus shielding aluminum foil plus PVC insulation layer. Sure, it's not bad cable for PVC jacketed cable, but it's not exactly what I wanted.
All right, let's see if this last and largest package can be a banger to end the show with. Feels like there's some padding in there. It does feel kind of donut-y again. There's no labeling on the outside of the package, of course. Oh, what are you? That's not cable. We've got some mounting clips, power injection. Oh, is this that neon LED light strip stuff? Let's go check the listing, see if it says what voltage it is, and we'll light that up.
Neon strip, DC 12 volts. 2835, 120 LEDs per meter, home DIY, neon sign, flexible ribbon rope LED strip, white, blue, pink, yellow, green, 1, 2, or 5 meters. And of course, I bought 4 meters according to my listing, and I got the white one. But what I really wanted to know from here is 12 volts. Not much more information about it down here. Internally, it's SMD LEDs of size 2835. 120 LEDs per meter, IP65, and if I got 5 meters, 4 meters, 1224, 480 LEDs, I guess. Well, let's see what happens.
So let's connect it to my power supply. It's set to 12 volts, current limit about 1.5 amps. Let's see what happens. There we go. Yeah, I'd call that white. That's cool. And the whole thing is drawing about 1.2 amps. That's not bad. I could see that being neat stuff to align a sign with or something like that. Bends nice and tight. And the cool thing about this stuff, as opposed to a normal LED strip, is you can't really see the individual LEDs in it. There are cut marks along the back every couple of centimeters or thereabouts, so that's a safe place to cut it. You can just barely make out the individual LED chips inside the sections when you're looking from the side, but not from the show face that normally you would be seeing it from when it was deployed. So, and yes, I know Big Clive's talked about this stuff multiple times, but I like to see stuff for myself. I like to have it available to play with. What's going on here? Oh, just a bad connection over there. Yeah, just a dodgy connection in there. Well, that's not ideal. Dielectric grease. I mean, good, but now I got to deal with that, trying to figure out how to make a better connection in there. Looks like I'm going to have to strip it back a little bit. But that's another project for another day. And there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite the variety, as always. Some surprises and some very useful things, such as these USB adapters. Those will help me not have to keep unplugging and plugging in things when I'm doing various projects and work around here. It's just nice to be able to leave USB cables plugged into the computer rather than having to unplug and juggle them around all the time. Useful. Also useful, these header pins that my anonymous donor sent me. I always try to keep these in stock, and I reorder them relatively frequently, so now I've got a handful more to add to the collection, and it'll be a little bit longer before I have to reorder them. Nice. Then we have these little conductive rubber switch pad things. Again, there's 100 of them, 10 different shapes or 10 different sizes in there, and one or two remote control repairs will, well, probably one remote control repair will pay for this kit itself. So good thing to have in stock for when I eventually need it. This cable, I'm fairly confident that I was hoping to get microphone cable. This is two pair. It's got overall shield. It's got twisted pairs. And again, I should be able to use it. That's not a big deal. It's just not exactly what I ordered. Still, handy stuff to have around. And then there is this neon LED, neon rope white stuff. It's just cool. I haven't had much of a chance to play with it. I do have one other strip of it that I think is different colors or RGB or something. But I thought this one would be good too, just for illumination, for outlining signs and stuff like that. And I always just like to have an assortment of LED strips of various different types around for when my muse moves me to do some kind of a project. Anyway, that's all for today. Thank you to my anonymous donor. Thank you to my YouTube channel members and Patreon supporters who help me buy this stuff, keep the beer fridge full. That's always nice. And yeah, just keep the videos interesting around here. Thank you very much, folks. And of course, to viewers like you, thanks for watching. Questions or comments down below. I'll talk to you later.